Greetings, fellow Oathlings. Welcome to some more Elder Scrolls Arena. The task at hand today is to search for the next place. Well, actually, we need to search for the crystal-like war tower. So, yeah, my bet is it is somewhere in the Summerset Isle, the Isle of Summerset. So I'm just gonna take a risk and go over there. I mean, if we're wrong, we're bound to find out anyway. So, yeah, and before that, just look at this place. I mean, I just entered the Mage's Guild and it was all fine, and when I come out it's all foggy. I mean, have I like pissed off the mages or something? Anyway, at least I have a dude here to keep him company, and unfortunately we're gonna have to leave you behind. So let's go ahead and jump into the Somerset Isle, and I guess we can try going to Firsthold. But I think that's where the crystal-like law tower should be, because it is you're supposed to be able to see the mountain range from there. So I think we'll go for Lillandril. 70 days, come on. Alright. I mean, I'm gonna be an old man by the time I complete my journey. You've arrived in the city state of Lillandril in the Somerset Isle province. The date is Mondas, 28th of Sun's Dawn in the year 3rd Era 390. It took 70 days to reach your goal. Of course it did. More than 2 months. Welcome to the Lillandril, the high elven hold on the northern coast of Somerset. The people fight here for honor and glory. Come, challenge our land if you dare. Man, these guys are confrontational. And what the hell is up with all this fog? What time is it? 5:02 in the afternoon. You mean like, it's the evening? Okay, we've got the dancing jug here, and is there nobody here whom I could ask a question? Why is this entire place like a ghost town? Ah, finally a person. And I guess this guy does look like an Altmer. I mean, with the yellow skin and all. So, who are you? My name is Cormon Larithlock, the Mason. I have been repairing some stonework at the Conclave of Charity Temple all day. Good to know. And where is the Crystal Tower? It is said that the Mage's Guild seeks a Crystal Tower for some artifact of great power with which they can fight the followers of the Mad God. Perhaps if you were to go to the Mage's Guild and ask them, they would agree to help in return for some payment. And, well, looks like we lucked out. I mean, I didn't expect to get to the exact place at the first try, so I would check to the southeast if I were you. Thank you very much. Well, luck's in our favor, I suppose. One of the things which I really don't understand is, okay, I walked myself into something. So one of the things which I don't really understand is why, I think this is a major skill, by the way. No, it's not. It might be somewhere here. It's difficult to see where we are going and where it might be with all this fog, but anyway. Yeah, one of the things which I don't understand is why all the cities in the south have got like the same architecture and stuff. If you did go through the trouble of giving all the different themes and skins to the cities, you might as well have just, I don't know, give all the cities like different architecture. Not all the cities, but at least all the provinces. So, where's the Mage's Guild? East. Okay. I would rather not take a swim. We've got a priest here. And where is the Mage's Guild? Ah, it's right here. Snow and wind swirl about as you enter the Mage's Guild and shut the door. Outside, the winter snow falls without any signs of stopping. You stamp your feet and crowd close to a brazier that glows hot with fiery coals. As the warmth slowly seeps in, you notice arcane implements and mystical apparatus. You think you feel a strange tingling over your skin. Let's just hope we don't turn into Spider-Man. My name is Corim Ashlen, and I have the dubious honor of being the lore master of this mage's guild. Word has spread that you seek the Crystal Tower. Unknown students of mine just search an entire lifetime never destined to walk within its hallowed halls. I will, however, consider doing something I would never have never thought to do. I will help you find the Crystal Tower. In return, you must do a favor for me first. You see, a few nights ago, priests of the Mad God attacked our guild. They were protected by some sort of spell that absorbed our magic, making us powerless to stop them. Many of our initiates died, and the priests carried off a number of our treasured artifacts. Shogarath. Among these was a small diamond. I cannot speak more of this, other than to say it serves a vital purpose here in the guild by strengthening our magic. It has a secondary function as well, one that would be of interest to you. I quested and won this magical gem in fair combat from its previous master, the Demi-Lich Zarephus. It is said that the light from the gem will allow the viewer to see the true location of the Crystal Tower on a specially prepared map, a map I have in my study. The priests, however, have the diamond. If you would consider recovering it, I would be happy to show you the location of the Crystal Tower. You will, however, have to bring me the diamond first. Do you agree? Of course I do. I mean, not like I've got much of a choice here. And I doubt the diamond part, but alright. Good. You will find the Temple of the Mad God outside the city of Lillandril. Wait a moment while I get a pen and mark the location on your map. Can't you, like, do your magic stuff and just mark it on its own? You know, make it just appear on my map? I mean, another mage did that. Anyway, wait a moment while I... Oh, yeah. Remember, bring me the diamond and I will show you the location of the Crystal Tower as a reward. Corim inscribes the location of the Temple of the Mad God onto your map. Well, at least I'm lucky that, you know, Shogarath doesn't get mad when I fuck this followers. I mean, he sort of enjoys that. Although, if he does take a liking to me, he would probably look to kill me sometime. 5:29 in the afternoon. Alright then, I suppose I shall be making my way to, excuse me, to the Temple of the Mad God now. It's a little ways away, but alright. 4 more days. Hey, I mean, I've got all the time in the world, right? And we are here in the dungeon. The Temple of the Mad God. And I don't really think they have decided the names of all the gods at this point. Because if they had, then... Wait, what? Ah. No worries. I can hear skeletons. Yeah, right here. Blade Greaves. Nah. I mean, we can start exploring here, but okay. I have the feeling that we're gonna have to, you know, like, actually take a swim in this level, because this level just has a layout like that, so... Anyway, I mean, if it has to be, then it has to be, right? So, I'll just save the game here quickly. I mean, I usually do that every time I start a dungeon, because you know how dungeons are. I'm wondering if I should equip my 12 gold pieces, thank you very much. If I should equip my mace instead of this thing, because I mean, they are better against skeletons, and because this level sort of started with skeletons, something tells me that there are more where these things came from. And that is one interesting coffin. Complete with blood and all. So we came from this way. We can try going straight. We can try exploring this side. I don't think there is much to this side. The map doesn't scroll any further, so this might just be a loot room. So, doesn't hurt to check, does it? It's this way? Nah. It's the one right in front of us. Ah, nice. Nothing usable, no gold for me. That is fine. I do not have many problems with that. And my only question is, holy shit, is that like a monk? It's a she-monk that's kicking me. And she is causing a lot of damage. Damn. I don't know that this game had like a monk class. She just won't go down. Look at all the hits she's taking. And her clothes change as soon as she falls over. A war axe, which she wasn't using? That is... huh. Quite strange to say the least, but... oh well, whatever catches your fancy, I guess. I didn't mean to fall into the water. Ah, spiders. I hate spiders. I mean, not really, I don't exactly have anything against them, but... they just paralyze you and I don't like that. They're not considerate. They're inconsiderate bastards. Is what I'm trying to say. Let me just go ahead and heal up real quick, and... yeah, right here. So this is certainly a new area, I suppose. Is this... no, it's not. I thought this was like the way to the next level or something. I guess there's only one way through here. It's a coffin placed in the middle of nowhere. Who opened this door? Ah. That guy there. I wonder if vampires come out of these. Or whether they're there as a part of, you know, the necrophilia program. A ring. I will be taking that, thank you. I don't know why, but that was looking like a secret door of some sort. Hellhounds. Really? This mace is taking a lot of time to kill, but... it works, I guess. I guess this mace doesn't really have that higher damage. Interesting. It seems more like the river's just following... okay, strange room. Oh shit, I missed these guys. What it looks like is that this river is sort of... oh shit. Yeah, I mean, I guess it is the temple of a mad god, so... it would make sense to have... like a human in here. A katana. Let's see. Nah. I mean, I will pick that up later. From the enemies that I get later in case I don't find enough loot. But I shall save my space for magic items first. Another monk. Forty-five gold pieces, and all of these people have weapons which they're not using, which sort of seems a little strange to me. I mean, these guys look like they're highly trained in Taekwondo, you know, they're just using kicks for the most part. No weapons. 46 gold pieces. I mean, I can appreciate that. I appreciate all the gold that I'm getting from these enemies, but where's the loot though? I mean, I would like to have some enchanted items to check out at least. I mean, it's not like I need the money. I've got 34,000, more than 34,000 gold as it is, so... huh. Let me just save right here for the sake of making it thus far. And we've got a barrel here, we've got two barrels here. We can try going deeper into the dungeon, or we can just... Let's check out this room first. For whatever it is worth. There seems to be an entire area back there, and I think I should make sure that I have all the places checked out before proceeding onwards onto a different part of the map. And this was sort of a pointless room. I mean, it has nothing. I guess... I mean, I wonder if the things which, you know, you can hear breathing from time to time, if they're actually like vampires waking up. And something really tells me that I do need to swim in order to finish this level. Because this river is certainly leading somewhere around this end, and there isn't really any other way to go about it. I mean, you have to take a swim. You know what, let's just check it out. Ice wolf. Sorry, snow wolf. Another one. All these doors have like... I don't know why, but the game has like this red dot which you can see from time to time. And that's sort of, you know, that's sort of confusing to me. See, like, for example, we just walked by a red dot. I don't know if you noticed it or not, but it certainly was something. I have no idea what it was, but it was something. I guess this answers that. So, we'll just continue swimming, I guess? I don't know. I just hope that a wraith doesn't get me, you know, all of a sudden. And they've got some Christians here. I mean, you've got a Christian gravestone there. So, I don't know, Shugarath was a Christian. Or at least worshipped by Christians. Someone comes to attack me. It's another orc! And what is an orc doing in a place of worship? A place of worship of the mad god, Shugarath, instead of, you know, worshipping his own god. Own god, Malush, Malakath, or whatever else you would like to call him, really. Huh. Oh shit. And I bet this chick is wearing some of the other, you know, sort of armor on her. Because she's blocking a lot of my shots. Nope, nothing. Just a flail. Okay. Really? And this one has a very high agility, I can barely hit her. On that note, just a sec, what is my agility? 77? How did it drop so low? But... what? Huh. Ballroom of agility. Huh. But why is it 77? It should be like 100. I think I made sure that my agility was at 100. It's quite strange how this, game sometimes remembers data and stuff like that. And does this do anything? Nope. It's a simple magical ring. That's quite strange, I would say. Is it because I'm fatigued? No, I'm not fatigued either. Is it because I'm diseased? Is it because I'm carrying too much? Nope. I guess I've got more space for improving my agility, I suppose. Did my agility drop out of somewhere? Okay, something. It's a wraith right here. I don't know whether this is a wraith or a simple ghost. I mean, the next time I see one, I suppose I shall just check up on it. And more water for us to swim. And this doesn't have any text for us, unlike the previous dungeon. Nothing here, I can hear skeletons all the way over there, where they should remain. Let me just check real quick here. So, I take this off, I take this off. That is only 20 points. That makes it 30. How is my agility 47? I am dead certain that my agility had rolled all the way up to, I don't know, I mean, I think my agility had gone all the way up to 70 or something, if I remember correctly. Which I suppose I do. So, I don't know why my agility is so low right now. I'm getting hit more and I'm unable to hit all of a sudden. I mean, at least the way this river is headed and, we've got all these skeletons and stuff in our path. It sort of makes me guess that we're going in the right way, but I would really like to know what happened to my agility. It shouldn't be this low. And I just hope I didn't take a wrong turn here. There's a thing here. Let me try from this side. And hopefully I'll be able to make it. Yes, I did. I wonder if I should rest here for some time. And I'm healed. Oh wait, that's the way down. Cool. I suppose we could have come through here as well, but yeah, we'll just check it out on the way back, I suppose. Unless it is too difficult to do so. But yeah, basically, I shall save the game here once, and I shall then proceed along to the next level to complete my mission. That sounds like an orc and a dead body. Awesome. 80 gold pieces in a crystal, that's what I'm talking about, that's the kind of loot I like. The ones which you need to pry from the cold dead fingers of human beings dead long before you. There's a cage there. And I don't understand this part about the ladder levels where there are like this shadows everywhere and you can't see a damn thing. Okay, that was either a gate or like a secret door of sorts. But then again, all the secret doors I've seen do open like gates, so I suppose it could have been that. It's a monk! A warrior monk. Am I hitting? No, I'm not. So if you stroke your sword upwards like this, you have the maximum chance of actually hitting somebody. But... okay. Yeah, look, my agility is 63 now, and... that should give me at least 93 agility, but it isn't. Strange. One to strength, one to willpower, and... I suppose one to agility. 29 gold pieces, amazing. And I shall save, just for the sake of saving, since I did just get, like, leveled up, so... a pillar, amazing. I've got no clue where I'm going, but yeah. I mean, in dungeons that are as dank as these, it is, it can be a wise strategy to, no, that's not loadable, to actually like just keep exploring, and when you feel like you're getting stuck, then just, yeah. I am going up, right? Wait, let me just check. Nope. Not that, yeah. Just explore and then at a later point in time just open your map up and check where you are. So I guess that was... what the hell is this? Should I be healing right now? I mean, this dude hasn't hit me, but yeah, no, that's fine. See, my agility is 94 now. I guess I'll just equip the Elven Longsword of Strength for this time, for the time being, and let me go ahead and heal quickly before continuing to fight with this monster of a thing, whatever this is. Is this like a centurion? Nope, it's an iron golem. Whoa, holy shit, come on man. Dude, seriously? Are you even killable? I mean, I haven't landed a single hit on you yet. You've been blocking all my attacks. Do you need to be killed by magic or something? Let me try that real quick. Nope. Nothing. Is this some trick to you which I'm not getting? Because you are blocking all my attacks here. Let me try something else. Let me use the ebony blade instead. Maybe this will do the trick, because the ice golems you cannot attack. Ah yes, look at that. So apparently if you want to defeat these guys, you need an ebony weapon. Anything subpar is not going to cut it. And that is one truly terrible sight. Saving. Just so, just in case we face another one of these guys and die all of a sudden. Where's it gone? Really? This guy did that much damage? So, as I was saying, the ice columns from the... which one was it? The Fortress of Ice? So, ice columns, you need at least... an elven weapon if you want to defeat them. A weapon made of elven metal. So yeah, I just guess that this or this golem might have like a similar thing to it, where it might need like a note on the floor instructs someone to move things to the secure storage area in the northeast before any meddlers arrive. Indeed, the room has been emptied. I see. Except for this loot here. Amulet and longsword. Now, is the longsword enchanted? Nope. don't want to be carrying that around. To the northeast. Well, to the northeast we go then.